Amen. I thank God for yet another opportunity to speak the word. And I give God the glory for his mercy upon every one of us. This morning, or let me say this night, I want to speak briefly on the power of the Holy Spirit. Power of the Holy Spirit. And the main word that is coming out of that and theme is that we should be conscious of the power we have received. That is just what we want to talk about. We must be conscious of the power we have received. This message came into my mind as I was praying because I discovered that God has blessed us. Like our sister was saying the other time, God has blessed us. We have been blessed. And I want to assure us that the miracle has started. We are beginning to, we can feel it in our spirit that a lot of things have been deposited into our soul, I mean to our spirit. God has released his power. Every night we appear in his presence, the anointing has been dropping upon our lives. So we are loaded, we are stronger, and we know that the vision is becoming clearer to us. But one thing we must be conscious of is that we must be conscious of that power we have received. Remember that when Jesus Christ was about to go, he told disciples in the book of Acts, you know, he said they should not go, but they should wait for the power of the Holy Spirit. And that is in Acts chapter 1, verse 5 and 8. He said, for John truly baptized with water. He said, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost, not many days hence. Verse 8, he said, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be my witness both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Jerusalem and Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the heart. That is enlargement. That is expansion. The Lord will expand them. The Lord has prophesied that word. And because, you know, they cannot do this thing with their power, the work ahead of us, the enlargement God is talking about, the astonishing increase and expansion God is talking about, is not by our strength. That is why God said we should wait. And we have been waiting upon him for past almost 30 days now. It will soon be end. What a great God we serve. He won't push you out without preparing you, without equipping you. And we have been waiting together. It has never been like this before. I know in my ministry, we have been waiting. We have waited for 40 days, fasting and prayer. We have been doing this, but this time around, to all over the world, God gathered us together in his presence. And he has been giving us his strength, his power. You know, he commanded it and he made it happen. It's like we're in a hall all over the world. He gathered his saints together. It shows that God really means business. And he wants us to be well equipped before we go out there. That is the essence of all those messages God has been sending to us. Just like the disciples. And you see, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. God fulfilled his word. They spoke in tongues, they received power. They started ministering the word of life. Peter was afraid before he became so strong. He was able to minister to crowd, tell them about the Lord Jesus Christ. Souls were getting saved. Miracles were happening. Imagine they saw a cripple beside the temple and they just, you know, we don't have money, but we have this. They declared the power of the Holy Ghost. Anointing was just flowing because they waited in the Lord's presence. So I want us to believe that you have received it. We have waited. God has poured down his power. We are not ordinary. Whatever the way you see yourself before, receive new understanding right now. Be conscious of that power. Be conscious of that power. Don't listen to the devil. These people waited for 10 days and they received power from on high. We have been waiting now for almost 30 days in God's presence, fasting to be strengthened as he has promised us, incredible enlargement, astonishing expansion, you know, all those wonders he has promised us. And I want you to believe it. But you must be conscious of what you have received. You know what happened to the disciples? Later, they got distracted. You know, if you open your Bible to Acts chapter 6, verse 2 to 4, they got distracted from that anointing and the power God has given unto them. Something else occupied their time. They have no time for prayer again. They have no time for the word. They started, you know, thinking of how to take care of people, the widows and everything. And before you know it, things started happening within the fold. No more unity. The devil was sneaking in gradually. That is when we are not conscious of the power we receive. Acts chapter 6, verse 24 says, then the disciples, when they saw this thing happening, then the disciples called the multitude of disciples unto them and said, Acts 6, 2 to 4. Then the 12 called the multitude of disciples unto them and said, it is not good, no reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you, seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, who will be appointed over this business. Now see that what happened at verse 4. He said, but we give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. When we are closer to God, when we testify our prayer life and the word life, you know, this our spirit will be stronger. We will not be distracted. See what happened to them here? They discovered that they are moving away. That power is need food. The power of the Holy Spirit you have received need food. You need to feed that spirit that you have received from God. The anointing you have received from God need to be fed. As we proceed in this journey, don't say we have finished 30 days fasting and prayer and then you start doing whatever you want to do. No time for prayer again, no time for the word again, no time for your, you know, the relationship you have been enjoying God's presence, because nobody is talking every night again. You can't sleep from morning to night without prayer. No, you must not do that because you are still fighting. You're on the battlefield. The battle is the Lord, but it's working through you. So the devil still hates you. These people woke up. They were able to woke up from their slumber and they say, we have to do something. We have to be consistent. We have to be focused on what God has given you to do. And what happened when they change their strategy, when they focus on God, when they give themselves to prayers, when they give themselves to the word of God, when they change, they quickly move back to their leader, I mean to their savior, their strength, their power, that is God. They quickly mend the relationship back again. And what happened? That is verse Acts 6, 7. The Bible says, and the word of God increased, and the number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient to the faith. How Makuria Masa. That is what will happen. After receiving this power, don't let us relax and rest. When they woke up from that, see what happened. God took over. And not the power of God moved in the land. Souls were coming to the Lord. They received new power. The anointing, the power in them just move up like that. That is the will of God for us. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The same thing happened to Gideon. Remember Gideon in the Bible? Let's quickly Judges chapter 6, verse 11 to 12. He said, and there came an angel of the Lord and sat under an oak which was in Ophrah that pertained unto Joash the Abiezrite and his son Gideon, threshed wheat by the windpress to hide it from the Midianites. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. And the Lord looked upon him and said, verse 14 says, go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the land of the hand of the Midianites. Have I not sent thee? You know, Gideon didn't know that he has any power, but he was an Israelite. The anointing is there. The power is where he did not know. You know, he was questioning the angel. He said, you are saying that I'm a man of, he said, the outcome, that's Judges chapter 6, verse 13. And Gideon said unto him, oh, my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befalling us? And where be all his miracles, which our father told us of, saying, did not the Lord bring us from Egypt? But now the Lord hath forsaken us and delivered us unto the hand of the Midianites. You see, he thought it was just a story, But God is real, and that was what God wanted to tell him, that I'm still your God. I can still perform the same miracle I performed years ago. Only you just need to mend your way and come back to me. If you see what happened to that guy when he had the word of the angel, you see, he changed his way. See what happened. Verses 25 to 26. He said, and it came to pass that same night, the Lord said unto him, take thy father's bullock, even the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that the father had, and cut down the grove that is by it. Verse 26, and built an altar unto the Lord thy God upon the top of this rock in ordained place, and take the second block, and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove, which thou shalt call down. You see, when this man made his ways, God told him, sacrifice to me. Go and use that thing your father is using to worship Baal. He could not do it during the day because he was afraid of the people, but he woke up in the middle of the night to throw down the altar of Baal. He made sacrifice unto the Lord. He changed so many, you know, he rose up to know that God. And when he called upon the Lord and sacrificed the Lord, what happened? Power came. He was able to go in that power. He became conscious of the God of Israel, that just so we have power, but something has been limiting the power in their life. Sin, you know, moving away from God has limited that power. So what are we saying today, brethren? We have received the power. Don't let the enemy take it away from you. You must be, number one, you must be conscious of that power. When Gideon knew the God of Israel, though he had heard the story, but when he personally knew that God, the power came. It came upon him, and he was able to go in that strength that God has given him. In this prayer session, we have received power. Believe it, my brethren. Don't doubt it. Don't listen to the devil. Don't listen to the voices from the hand of from the other side. Don't be distracted. Don't start doing what God has not sent you. You are not alone. You are a great man. We are great. We are great. We are great. We have the power of God in us. Be conscious of who you carry. Give him food as you eat 3 times a day. Feed your spirit man. If you stop praying, you will be going down. If you stop committing, having your relationship with your God, it will affect your strength. The spirit man want to eat. Give him that. Give him spiritual food. Take your time to seek God. After this prayer, you must not withdraw and go back to your normal life. You are a new person now. I'm telling you, the anointing will work for you as you are conscious of who you are. You are a new person. The hand of God is upon you. You cannot spend 30 days in God's presence and think you are not playing. God has done something powerful. I'm telling you, I feel so different. I saw God in a different way during this time of fasting and prayer. So I believe the same for you. I believe the same for you. Even if you have not seen some things happening physically, I'm telling you, you are a man of war. You are a strong man. Go in that mind. Don't let it go away. Don't let it distract you from God. That is what happened to Gideon. When he rose up, he changed so many things. He changed in his father's house. He removed the altar of Baal boldly because he wanted to see that God. He became new in the hand of God. And God was able to walk through him. He was able to deliver the Israelites. God is sending us out, my brethren, wherever you are, in your place of work, in your community. You are going to be a savior to many as God will begin to walk through you. But that is when you are conscious of who you are. Don't go back to that whole life you have been living. Whatever however terrible your past may be, it is gone. God doesn't see that old man again. He sees you, a brand new person, the way he saw Gideon. As far as God is concerned, Gideon is anointed. He's a seed of Abraham. He's delivered. But see, even though they have been delivered, they are still living in slavery. They are still trying to hide away from the enemy. because they are yet to know who they are. But when he knew who he was in God's presence, and removed all those hindrances, even from his father's house, he became new again. He entered into that thing, the covenant God has made with his fathers. He began to see the miracle he has read about and heard about. I'm telling you, you are a bundle of miracle. Whatever might be the problem in your family or in your place of work or in your life, I'm telling you, God has done something great in your life in these 30 days. Rise up in faith in God. Rise up in the power of the anointing. Even when tell the devil you are delivered from his hand, you are no longer a slave. You have given your life to Jesus. You have the power of God in you. You cannot be under this prophetic utterance every night and still remain the same. Hold on to what you have been given and keep moving. Even when the devil, look at Peter, Jesus said, come, and he walked on the sea. You can walk over that problem. Or sickness or disease, they cannot kill you. They will go back to the sender because you have the anointing of God in your life. Any problem that is affecting your life must go. Stand on the promise and the anointing you have received. Let the anointing speak for you. But you must keep it. You must be conscious of the anointing. You must know who you are right now. You don't play with sin. You must be committed to God. God wants that relationship. You see, from that time henceforth, God began to talk to Gideon, giving him instruction. God wants to speak to you. He wants to show you things. He is living in you right now, but he was giving him attention. Let him know that you want to hear him. Wake up in the middle of the night and talk to your father. Speak to him. Instead of carrying your problem out there to expose to the world, go to your father and let him know how you feel. He wants to help. He's so close to you than your family. God is so interested in our life because of the assignment he has placed before us. He's given us incredible enlargement. See what happened to Gideon, if you raise it. When his ways changed, when he moved closer to God, when he did the right thing in the Lord's presence. Look at the disciples, when they change their lifestyle and they are committed to God, things begin to happen. We are going to experience wonders and miracles in our life this year more than ever before in the mighty name of Jesus. Heaven will open upon us. We shall see new things. Wonders up. God wants to walk through us in this world this time around. Let's cooperate with him. Be conscious of who you are. You are a man of war. You are an overcomer. You cannot be defeated. God is in you. Hold on to that and keep it in your spirit. Move close to God in your prayer life. Be prayerful. Read the Bible. Let God minister to you. And be holy. Be holy. Run away from sin. That is what Gideon did. He removed every works of the devil, every addressing of the enemy upon them. He cleared them from the way so that he can now present his body, a living sacrifice unto the Lord. That is our work. Henceforth, even after this prayer, you are continue to minister to yourself. As you minister to yourself in God's presence, God begins to walk through you to reach the world. And I'm telling you, we are going to walk. We shall not be tired. We shall walk with God. We shall run with God. And I'm telling you, we are going to fly like eagle in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God lives in you. Always remember this. You carry God. You carry his anointing. You carry his power. Guide it jealously. Don't throw your glory before the dogs. Be careful of your association. Live right with God. Be conscious of what you have received for this past almost 30 days. Hey, be conscious you are not ordinary person. Whatever they want to bring to this coin, tell the devil that's not your portion. I've received my victory. I've received my power. I'm walking with God. Yes, you are not going to die because the anointing has been placed upon your life. You will live. Everything God said we are going to do, we are going to do it. No powers of darkness can overcome the light because God is in you. You carry him. He wants to showcase his power through you. So make your life available for him. Be conscious of your lifestyle. Be conscious of your lifestyle. Let God be glorified in your life. And you will see that by the end of this year, we are going to look back together and begin to give testimony. That sickness cannot stand in your body. That disease can, is not your portion. You are God. You are God hand. You are God leg. You are God everything about God. You carry God inside of you. You are an overcomer. But be conscious of who you are, please. Let us walk in that victory. Our victory is in Christ Jesus. And at the end of this year, we are going to worship God together. Because greater things must have been done. Wonderful things. You will experience it. The incredible enlargement, you will experience it. The astonishing wonders and enlargement and expansion, you will experience it. In your place of work, in your ministry, upon your children, your desire will be established. That is the mind of God. Gideon experienced it as weak as he was before, but when he walked with God, he became another man. He became great man. And he was like that before, but because a lot of things distracted him. But when he came into the Lord's presence and he walked right, he received what God has given him. The same thing with disciples. When they were moving, getting tired, being distracted away from God, see what happened. But when they came back to see God, to seek him and to be in his presence, the anointing moved. So when it is God will do and you just be watching. God will just be walking to you and you'll be so. It will even surprise you when you begin, because that's what God wants to do. When we get something astonishing things, it's amazing. You will be surprised at the way God is working. Because you have been in his presence. He wants relationship. He wants to. God, nothing is too small to ask him. Nothing. Don't think you are wise. I'm telling you, that's the essence of prayer. The more you pray, the more you see God working wonders. Pray with your family. Read the scripture. Study the word of God. Live holy. Live right. I'm telling you, with faith in him, you will see God working through you, working in your life, blessing lives, enlarging your cause, expanding it. That will be our portion this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But I pray that you will not lose sight of this blessing you have received. You will not be distracted from it. Focus on that God you have received. Focus on God and go to his presence. Don't say, I'm wise. I can do it. There's something you think you can do. But when you ask God, the wisdom he will release, you'll be surprised. How he will do it, you'll be surprised. He wants relationship. That is what God wants this year. And the more we give it to him, the more we present our work, the more we begin to see his power moving on our behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, may the Lord bless you, the Lord enlarge your cause, and establish our life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we are grateful because you are our Father. You are a faithful God. You don't ever change. We pray, Lord, that as many as have partaken in this prayer that you have called together unto yourself and you have released your anointing upon our life. Oh, we pray, Father, that the anointing will remain with us forever in the name of Jesus Christ. The world will not take it away. Distraction will not take it away. Like Mary, she saw Jesus Christ. I mean, like Martha, she has no time for the Lord Jesus Christ. But Mary stayed there. And Bible says, as she sees things that nobody can take away from her. Oh, Lord God of heaven, we pray today. Everything we have received, Jesus, we'll be so committed to you. We'll be so conscious of it. The power will not leave us alone. We'll be fully granted in you. So we will enter into serious relationship with you. You will transform our personal life, our prayer life, our word life, our life will be cleansed in your presence. You will cause us to be holy, to be like you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for this year. Year of victory, year of enlargement, year of expansion. Lord, it shall be ours. I will walk in it with you in us. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.